Developing a wide investor base is always in the interest of the capital markets, as it helps check excess volatility, deepens the liquidity pool, and reduces the cost of transactions. When these are matched with the effects which the Nigerian capital market has had on the Nigerian economy, it creates an urgent challenge which must be addressed by stakeholders at all levels to foster a strong and robust economy capable of creating sustainable wealth and withstanding sudden foreign portfolio investor exit shocks. The NSE, by its own efforts and in collaboration with various stakeholders, has embarked on several initiatives to boost retail participation. These initiatives are geared towards improving financial literacy and eliminating all forms of market abuse to ensure investor protection. The exchange recognizes the benefits as well as the potential negative impact of retail participation on the market and on the individual investors. In recognition of the importance of a fair and orderly market to the deepening of retail participation, NSE has implemented several initiatives to enhance investor protection and protect market integrity. These include development of a world-class market surveillance system, SMAS, in partnership with NASDAQ, and the reconstitution of the Investors Protection Fund, IPF, in 2012, to compensate investors who suffered pecuniary losses as set out by the framework of the fund. In 2018, the NSE will focus on driving its 2018 to 2021 strategic plan, which will position the NSE as a more agile and globally competitive demutualized exchange with a broad, diverse range of products and quality listings to meet the needs of our global investors and wider stakeholder community. In the debt capital market, declining interest rates and yields could potentially catalyze new listings and refinancing of existing instruments for more favorable yields. Lastly, to enhance the competitiveness of Nigeria's SMEs and position them to list on the exchange, a concerted effort is required from government, lawmakers, and regulatory agencies to create a stable investment climate.
Let me quickly add that this recommendation is really to support the government's policy on the ease of doing business. So the other point has to do with listing by some medium to large corporates who really qualify for listing. We need to continuously sensitize potential issuers and investors about the benefits of participating in the market to encourage more listing. The last recommendation we have here for catalyzing listings is that the regulators and SROs should improve confidence in the market. So we've set markets to be transparent, there's price discovery, so that reliable data, so that investors and operators can operate in that market. But we also need to have close monitoring and enforcement of rules. So in conclusion, let me say the Nigerian capital market has a critical role to play in the transformation of the Nigerian economy, as it provides a platform for raising capital and mobilizing investable funds for investments in infrastructure and other critical sectors identified in the economic recovery and the growth plan.